What is up, guys? Austin Urcho here, and today we're doing an opening review, whatever you want to call it, of the Star Wars Dorbs. Now, these are the Dorbs that they've released. They're only at the Disney store, so we'll kind of take a look at the Luke one here first. So, as you can see, it's kind of hard to see the light, though, actually. There's a sign there that says Disney, so it's only, for some reason, these are only available at the Disney store, and it has the special, it says special edition little sticker there on the front. And so, we have all the Star Wars characters, so we have these here. And then there's, the store does have an exclusive Chewbacca that's a flocked version, but our store never had it, so I don't have that. And then there is a Han Solo on a Tauntaun release that I have ordered, and it's just not here yet at the time of doing this video, but I thought I'd just go ahead and do it. So we're just going to go ahead and look through each one, so we'll start with Luke first. So we have Luke Skywalker. So these are, as I said, at the Disney store, so if you have like a mall or something that has a Disney store, you'll be able to find these, and they're kind of sometimes hard to find, and then they're more expensive, which I don't like. They're more expensive than a pop for a Dorb, but they're Star Wars, so they can do that. So here's Luke, of course, with Dorbs. They all have their happy smiley faces, and they have the like closed eyes, like they're, you know, smiling real hard, and have just like the closed eyes or whatever. So here's Luke's feathered hair, kind of like he had in episode 4, and then his white outfit that he had from Tatooine and stuff there, and of course the lightsaber there on his belt, and then some other little pockets and stuff. So with Dorbs, there's not much to them, so we're not gonna like spend a whole lot of time on them or anything when you flip these around. So next up is Princess Leia, and I'm going in the order of their number, so 1 through 8 or whatever there is as she falls out. So next up we have Princess Leia, which of course is the Carrie Fisher. So it's sad about her death and everything, but hopefully they'll do some special for her in the movies and stuff now. So there's Princess Leia again with her happy smiley face. She does have her buns there on the side of her head, which look really cool and funny at the same time. And then there's her dress, and she has a nice like belt there and everything. And so that's really all there is to Princess Leia. I like the way they, how much detail they put in her hair and everything. So there's Princess Leia. Next up is Darth Vader. Everyone loves Darth Vader. And so, let's look at him now. So here is Vader. So there's, of course, his normal dark helmet. He does have the eyes still, as you can see, the white eyes painted on there. But he doesn't have the smile, obviously, because his face is covered up a lot more, so you can't see the smile. And so he has, of course, his breathing apparatus on there, and then his helmet and everything, which looks really cool. And I like these. This does have a cape, but I like how they did put the lightsaber. It just looks like a little popsicle, almost, to me, that he has in his hand. But, of course, then there's the detail on his outfit and everything. All the mechanics and stuff that go into his outfit. So there is Darth Vader. Next up is Han Solo. And so here is Han. So you can see, again, the face. You'll notice that on every single one. He has hair very, somewhat similar to Luke's in design, just obviously his goes up over the ear more, or yeah, the ears, I'll say. They don't have ears, but I guess he does have a little tiny ear there. And so still similar hair design and everything, just different color, brown. And then of course his outfit there with the like tan undershirt and the black vest and blue pants, and of course a belt. He does have his gun there in his hand, as you can see, and he does have a holster painted on too that he could obviously put in. And And so he had got his red stripe and everything. They put all the sorts of detail into this. And so there's the Han Solo. Next up we have his friend Chewbacca. So again, they do have a flock Chewbacca, which I don't have because I haven't been able to find. Oh god, they just fall right out of this. Hopefully I don't damage any of them. So here is Chewbacca. So he has a smiley face. He's got his black nose there. I like how they kind of make it look like a... It's hard to see, but the nose, it's not just a, you know, like a circle or anything. They put detail into it. And then I like his hair, how it all hangs down around his head and stuff, like his mane does. And then his body there, he does have his bowcaster. And I like how they even put a little bit of detail of it, like coming back like it's under his arm and stuff. I like the, how much detail they put on. And then he has his bandolier there around him with his little bag there on the side and everything, and then they put all the marks on it to make him look, you know, furry and stuff like he is. But it would be, I really wanted the flocked one, but since we couldn't find it, you know, I couldn't do anything about it. Then this is the one that has kept me from doing this video for so long, C-3PO. None of the stores had C-3PO, and I eventually had to go online and order a C-3PO to get him. And I don't know why. There's nothing special about him. It's just C-3PO, but apparently no one has him. And so here's C-3PO. He still does have the eyes and the mouth and stuff. He has his square mouth, but still happy mouth. But he's got his eyes, even though, you know, he just has the circle eyes and stuff. But he, look at the design there on his head and everything, all the, like, outer rim thing of this. I don't know what it is, but, like, his two halves coming together. He has the little point up there. Then on the back, he has the circle and everything, and on the sides of his head. And then there, he has his chest circle, which, or I guess more on his stomach there. And then all the wiring and stuff inside of him there, as you can see. And then all sorts of little robotic stuff, like on the legs, his little, the circles, like, on his legs and stuff. They've just put a lot, like I said, a lot of design and detail into, like, the lines and stuff on it. They're just flat, but they mark all the lines and stuff as they should be. Next up, we have the Stormtrooper. And so here we have the Stormtrooper now, and so there's his helmet. As you can see, he still does have the eyes, because they always want to throw that in to make him look all nice and happy. So you can see the detail there of the chin thing. I believe that's like their breather type things there that go around the helmet and everything. They put all that detail in and design, the little stuff on the side of the head and everything. Their band that they have around the top of the head, I don't know why. And then on their body, they do have their blaster guns, which I think is cool. And then all the details of the belt and everything, and the design on their legs and the chest, all the different separation of the armor pieces, a little pocket there on the belt, and just all sorts of stuff designed into that. So we have the Stormtrooper there. And then the last character out of this set is the Jawa. And so, I think these are based off the like original Star Wars toys. Like the characters they chose, which are just like the basic episode for the first Star Wars movie characters and stuff. But like all the different ones they had, it's like the Tusken Raider is like one of the only ones that are really missing. Probably some more, but. And so the Jawa still has its eyes, of course, they're on its black face, so you just see its like a little orange, or in this case yellow looking eyes in the movie and stuff. You never actually see like what its face is, if it is anything. And then it's got its all brown cloak, and I like the way they put the detail there on the hood and everything on it. And then it's got its like bandolier type things there around its chest, and its little tiny hands. They look really cool. He doesn't have any weapons, unfortunately. He could have had like the ray gun or whatever he zapped R2-D2 with, but he doesn't come with anything. Just has his belt detail, or the things around his chest, the bandoliers around, is all he's got there. So that's pretty much it for the Star Wars Dorb series. They like don't have much of anything, like their dorbs. They're basic and plain. But I wanted to get these open so I could get them moved up onto the shelves back here. Hopefully they'll all stand up there and fit. But like I said, they do have a Flock Chewbacca, so if you want to find that one, you can find it somewhere. I don't know how. And then they also have the Han Solo Tauntaun, which I will be getting at some point. I think it's shipped maybe already, maybe not, I don't know. I know I've ordered it is all I know. And I'll probably post a picture of it on like their Twitter. So if you want to see what it looks like, look for Twitter, Awesome Nerd Show, and you can see the pictures there. So that's pretty much it, like I said, for the Star Wars dorbs. Not much to them. They're just plain, simple, basic character dorbs just in the Star Wars figures as characters you've seen 50 million times. But I hope you enjoyed. If you did, let me know down in the comments below. Let me know which character you thought was the best out of this, and which one you like the most, or who your favorite character is out of this set. Whatever you want to tell me about the characters. And don't forget to subscribe to see more. So thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.